Good evening. Senator Lidia Thorpe has made an angry speech after she was threatened online in a neo-Nazi video. She claims the voice referendum is an act of genocide. The racist video has dominated debate 10 days out from polling day.
Faith in the voice to Parliament.
I'm just a very flawed Catholic.
The Prime Minister and religious leaders came together in support of the referendum. But all campaigning has been drowned out by racism. A neo-Nazi video has appeared online. In it, the man burnt the Aboriginal flag and threatened Independent Senator Lidia Thorpe.
The referendum is an act of genocide against my people.
She was surrounded by supporters as she responded to the online rant and took aim at the Prime Minister.
He wants the f***ing fascists to come out and get me?
I'm not going to engage in a debate like that.
The opposition leader also weighed in. The
Prime Minister's got us embarked on a path which divides our country, and it gives rise in this sort of an environment to radical lunatics.
Peter Dutton condemned the video, so did Anthony Albanese.
I have unfortunately seen that video, and once you see it, you can't unsee it. It is quite horrific.
The Australian Federal Police says it's investigating and the account that posted has been deactivated. But Senator Thorpe isn't convinced.
Where is my protection in this country?
This is potentially damaging to the Yes side because it sidelines the debate about the substance of the referendum and in its place generates negative headlines around the voice. In a push for positivity, another famous Australian has joined the Yes campaign.
But at least it's a bloody start.
Michael Caton's fictional character pursued a constitutional challenge in the castle.
It's the vibe.
But the actor insists this constitutional change is much clearer.
To be heard, to have a voice to Parliament. And that's all this is.
Ashley Raper for 10 News First.